To edit the initial view for a data source, we can right-click the data source in the Outline pane. The interface of the Edit Initial View dialog box provides access to a set of tools that we can use to modify the query. On the left is a list of all dimensions and measures available in the data source. The panes in the center enable us to add dimensions and measures to the columns or rows of the crosstab, or apply background filters. The results for the selected dimensions and measures are displayed in the Live Preview pane on the right, which is divided into Crosstab and Chart tabs. The query includes default measures and dimensions. Let's add another dimension. Note that the Crosstab in the Live Preview pane updates automatically. We can change the order in which the two dimensions display. Note that both the text and the key for the sales organization are displayed. We can change that to show the text only. Note that other options for modifying a dimension include filtering by member or input string, showing or hiding totals, and changing the member access mode. Each time we make a change, the Live Preview pane updates. If desired, we can temporarily suspend updates so that we can make multiple changes at the same time. To illustrate, we'll pause the automatic refresh feature, remove the order quantity and open orders measures from the crosstab, and then enable the refresh again. Note that the extra columns have been removed from the crosstab. Now let's change the number of decimal places for the values. Other options for modifying measures include changing the scaling factor, calculating the totals using other aggregation methods, and applying sorts. Now let's sort the values in descending order. Note that we can also sort values directly in the Live Preview pane. However, this type of sort does not affect the query and will not be reflected in any components based on the data source. In order for the sort to be reflected in the application, it must be applied to the dimension itself. The values are now sorted in descending order. In addition to displaying as a crosstab in the Live Preview pane, the same data is also available in chart format. For the chart, we can change the chart type, swap axes, and show totals if desired. Let's return to the crosstab. Once the initial view has been edited to display the desired data, we can either confirm our changes to return to the canvas, where we can add components and map them manually to the updated data source, or we can add an analytic component directly from the initial view. A crosstab has been added to the application based on the initial view. Let's save our changes. We have successfully edited the initial view of a data source. Visit www.sap.com/learnbi for more tutorials on Design Studio and other SAP Business Intelligence products.